Welcome everybody to the Latin Nerds Network. This, of course, is the Watchlist, your virtual TV guide, where on a weekly basis we review and talk about all the shows and movies that get released on across all platforms of streaming. And at the end of the show, we'll set you up for what's coming out for the following week to get everything queued up for you. So, of course, it's gonna be kind of an abridged version of today's show. There wasn't a whole lot of things that were released this week. But that being said, I'll introduce the individual who's going to be helping me discuss these couple of shows that came out, or movie anyway. That's, of course, live from Houston, Ambassador of Love, Señor Jaime, a.k.a. Chewy. How's it going?
Hey, brother, what's going on, man? Happy Sunday.
Happy Sunday. Happy Halloween.
Happy Halloween, yes. And importantly, happy birthday, Kaylee, my daughter.
And that's right, daughter's birthday, so everybody wins. Also, it's good to have an October birthday, I think. Dress up, get gifts, and it's still far away from Christmas, so you still get shit. Don't get gypped. So hope you guys have a good Sunday, good and safe Halloween. I'm sure most of you, like myself, went out like yesterday and all that good stuff. So that being said, Chewy, let's get to it, man. Come on, a couple of things. Like I said, it was a very, it's probably the
very light week.
The lightest week we've had doing this. But that being said, it gives us time to kind of revisit a couple of shows I want to talk about. I know you want to talk about one, so we'll do that first. This is both on Apple Plus. This is an Apple Plus thing here, though. So start with the first one. And I had a bone to pick with this one last week. Yeah. That's Invasion.
Tick. Oh, no.
I disagree. Yeah, you were two episodes in. I had seen the three that were dropped. And the biggest complaint was that, you know, three episodes and a show called Invasion is everything but Invasion. There's really nothing about anything about an invasion, aliens. Well, it was alluded to for the most part, but that wasn't really part of the focus of the show. I was hoping that would change. And I think when we spoke, you were positioned second episode where you thought that was going to change as well. And so now I saw the fourth one. Just to really continue, let me see what happened with the show. Maybe things changed. And dude, I'm off it. I'm off Invasion. I mean,
that was quick.
I mean, it's been 4 hours. Like, this show's an hour long, a little bit longer. And it's 4 hours. And we haven't seen anything about any fucking invasion.
They keep alluding. They keep showing little pieces and hints. But
yeah,
we're still waiting.
It's four hours of this crap.
I'm pot committed already.
No, I'm out. I can't do it. Because the show, if it was something a little more to it, fine.
But I understand. I mean, you're holding Jack 10 offsuit, you know, marginal flop. Get out now. Save yourself. Don't try to catch a straight or a toothpick. Get out now.
It's cost me too much to get that straight. I'm like, I'm going to fold the hand. I mean, it's
fold.
Yeah, because, and listen.
I agree with you, man. I was expecting from the previous, okay, kind of like, you know, Battle Los Angeles, which is one of these early 2000 movies, which was kind of cool, but, you know, it had a premise and stuff. And I was expecting coming out, okay, yeah, some setup, but, you know, let's get to the invasion piece. What's going on? And you know, I can appreciate the way that they presented it, but get to the moral of the story already.
Right.
I mean, I understand you have the couple, you have the soldier, you have the Japanese NASA agency. You have all these pieces kind of trying to put a puzzle together. Okay, right. I understand. This is all of a sudden we're getting invaded. We don't know what's going on, right? We're starting to slowly piece together. But they seem to emphasize a lot on the emotional characters and then trying to see it from their point of view. It's like, I don't need four different perspectives of the same puzzle.
Right, and it's actually more. It's like five or six or whatever the case
is. Well, I mean, I said there's four main ones, right? There's a couple, right? There's the guy in Pakistan or Afghanistan, the soldier, right? And his unit that got wiped out.
The Japanese woman and NASA.
The Japanese woman with NASA. And what was the other? Oh, the English kid.
The kid in London,
That one, I really understand why we didn't see him, man.
I don't either. Yeah, and that was also, and I forget, Sam Neill's character was a sheriff who they showed.
And that was a complete
bait and switch, man. They showed him the trailer. I'm like, oh, yeah. Sweet, Sam Neill.
Don't bait and switch me.
I mean, they showed the first episode, and 3 hours later, they haven't gone back to him. What was the
I was like, what was Oklahoma?
And many issues like this, and the stories are fine from their own part, but I get it. You know, you got to have the human element. Of course you do. And you got the struggle within, it's supposed to be the struggle within what's going on, and that alien invasion putting on pressure to situations that they're already in already, right?
Mm-hmm.
Or how this invasion has affected them, how they have to overcome both things. But here, these stories can be done without alien invasion. The married couple, okay, the husband's cheating on her. He was cheating on her before the invasion, right? Nothing's changed. That the invasion didn't cause that rift. the kids in the bus, they crash and they're trying to survive, and a car could have cut them off, the bus could have crashed. It has nothing to do with the invasion. You know, the guy in Afghanistan, you know, he lost his soldiers. It's just him. He's trying to survive or get out of there. But that could happen. They face the enemy. They got shot. And he's the last man standing. I mean, nothing really pertains to the invasion part of it. And that's the problem.
Except the NASA one. That's the only one.
The NASA's the only one. But then again, they allude to it here and there. It's like, okay, yeah. She's the woman who her lover was in the space station. He got, you know, I guess, struck by aliens. I don't know. And then it exploded and they died. And she's mourning that loss, which is fine. But I don't need 4 hours of her mourning that same situation. Let's get to the point. Yeah. So, yeah, I'm off the show. I was on the fence. I figured, let me get one more to see. And I can't do it. I just can't do it. And look, I really don't recommend the show. It's dull. Yeah. It's boring. If you want invasion, invading a sci-fi, you know, look into the, this is not. This is nothing. It's like you're telling me, oh,
so watch Independence Day.
Yeah, I'd rather watch that. I mean, that's a sad statement, but I'd rather watch that. I mean, don't you know, promise, you know, old school and give us, you know, Kramer versus Kramer. You know, you want to give me a comedy, make me laugh, you know, give me a sci-fi piece, give me some sci-fi. And there's nothing of that here. So the human element's there, but it's, yeah, that's about it. But I'm not. I'm off it. But that
it's just gone too slow. Maybe it changes, but it's just gone.
It may, but it's too late. You have to sit at least 4 hours, and I don't think something's really going to change. There's nothing showing me that these things are going to change. And listen, I don't care if they show aliens or not, but they could show, let us know that they're there. Let the humans know that, oh, they're there. The people involved don't even know what's going on. They have no idea. It's an invasion. So again, the invasion is not affecting their lives.
The previews that indicate that. That's why I'm still in. That's why I'm still
hoping. But
to get to at least four hours, because it could go longer. 4 hours of just the character development. It's way too much.
It's too much. Yes. I mean, if they show like not the aliens, but maybe that piece of the arm, and the presence is there, right? Give us something. Something's just scary when you don't show us something, and that's fine. But they're not even alluding to alien presence, you know, for the most part. So it's like, what am I watching? It's not good. But look, that being said, you know, I need something to, you know, wash this out. So this is another show on Apple Plus, which we talked about early on, which we both liked. I wasn't high on it at first. I know you were. A show that is a science fiction show that, you know, look at that, actually gives us science fiction, you know. Wow, good job, Apple Plus.
Go figure.
So yeah, so Foundation's one that is based off a book, which it's, again, this one starts off slow, but at least you had that sci-fi element, right? It's a very dense show, but I think the last 3 or 4 episodes have really been really great. I think they've advanced the stories, a lot of good shit. So Ju, I know you're a big fan of this one, so what are your thoughts?
Yeah. No, I am in. I mean, I'm glad to go all in with these tricks, man. There's so much to tell within what we see, right? And I knew it's going to take some time because this is dense material, a lot of books, a lot of characters, a lot of locations, a lot of moving pieces. But in a nutshell, is I guess we get to see from various points of view the crumbling of an empire, right? That's what we're seeing here. So let's say akin to the Roman Empire, right? That was the masters of the universe at one point, but then they came crumbling, and the fact is that played into it, right? Both religion, both unrest, technological advances, stuff. And this is a universe or a world where it's been around for thousands of years. So in this last episode, right, they discover a ship that's been missing for 700 years, right? So they've had technology and great method for a long, long time, and then for some respect, they kind of, the reason that they're the empire is because they've kind of kept that to themselves. That's how they exert control over the outlying systems, right? And so that's where a lot of strife comes up, where, you know, they're not actively sharing the technology. They're coordinate, controlling people. You see people starving of water. The guy comes in, I'll give you a world-building desalination water facility, right, to appease them and still maintain that control. But even through all that, you see the clues as far as this is going to fall apart real fast, real quick, right? This is how you build the scent. But it's dense, it's layered. I think it was episode 2 or 3 where they kind of gave us the flashback to the original Cleon the First, right? Yeah. This is that spawned the clones and his legacy, right? Which was the space bridge. Well, he died before it was completed. And then we go 400 years where it's destroyed. And we go another 34 years beyond that where they don't even care anymore. So it's like you get all these layered pieces, the economy between what's great and why it's stagnant to where now they're trying to rebuild from scratch again, and all the pieces involved. But it's a great acting. Lee Pace has been great in the various Cleon roles. Jared Harris which we thought was a bait and switch. Not so fast.
They didn't steal Neil's in this one.
Huh? Thank God for that. And now that we're starting to uncover more, they did the groundwork, they've done flashback to fill in, and now we're seeing, okay, where is this going and what's going to be happening, right? And all the moving pieces that I'm going with to wherever this is going. I haven't read the books, so I don't know what's going to happen, but hopefully it's leading me down the right path.
This is akin to something like The Expanse. I would say in terms of tone and pace, right? And they're both sci-fi shows, and they both cover, you know, a lot of time frame, and you know, a lot dense in characters and worlds, and et cetera, et cetera. So it's something I would compare it to that. I mean, it's not exactly the same thing, but it's in that vein, right? So if you like something like The Expanse, I think this is right up your alley, right? Very heady sci-fi. You know, yes, it's dense.
No, there is no handholding here.
No, right. Like I said, it's very head. Yeah, very head. It's like, here it is.
They jump around locations and time frames, and especially since we're dealing with the same emperor, right? And you have to pay attention, okay, is this the current one? Is this Dawn? Is this Dusk? Is it the previous iteration? So there's some episodes where you could quickly fall off the rails, but if you're paying attention and they do it in a way where it's intelligent, right? It's not this, oh, well, there's not a lot of exposition. Well, this is the same clan that was here 10 years ago saying, no, you mean
you can follow along. But again, they don't make it too, like, difficult to follow along. But yes, it's just said, if you pay, it's one of the shows you have to really focus on. It starts off slow, but again, unlike Invasion, there's a purpose behind it, right? We know what the grand scheme of it. They introduce the grand scheme, what the stakes, right? The galaxy and the you know, the construction of this empire, right? It's there, it's established, and how that's affecting everyone else around them, right? Mm-hmm. Invasion is an invasion, but it's not affecting anybody apparently. This is a really good show. It's one to watch on Apple Plus for sure. Obviously, if you're gonna,
and it looks.
I mean, that looks spectacular. This is one of the best looking shows on TV. Period. It's amazing.
The ship, the shots, the last one we had, the asteroid field with the mining operation and finding that special ship.
The spread no expense. It looks fantastic. This isn't like a sci-fi. It looks like shit. It looks really good, you know, like the last couple of years.
This isn't sci-fi on the sci-fi
show. Right. So, yeah, this is like legit. So yeah, it's a good show. You know, Mansquito and whatever. Awesome Mansquito. I want to hear you hit that kind of reference. But that being said, Chewy, so yeah, definitely I both highly recommend on both ends. But let's get to the new stuff, man. A couple of things dropped. So the first one was on Netflix. Not both on Netflix. It was on Netflix. It's a movie. Which is, of course, our Army of the Thieves, right? Which was it is a prequel to Army of the Dead. Of course, Zack Snyder's zombie film, and which came out earlier this year. I think we both liked. I liked it. It was fun. I enjoyed it. It was good. Yeah. It was well made. It was very entertaining. It's rare for a Netflix film, you know. But you know, you do get some here often. And so this one here, obviously, is taking the character, I think Sebastian, right? The German character?
Lockbreaker, yeah.
Yeah, he cracks a safe, who was in Army of the Dead, of course. It's telling his origins, so to speak. And, you know, he's kind of an aspiring, not say criminal, but he wants to crack safes, and he's got a YouTube channel trying to build that, you know, whatever.
He knows zero views.
Yeah, he knows a lot about the lore of the particular one guy who created these sets of safes.
Wagner
was the guy who created the safes. So he gets recruited by a team who, you know, team of thieves, and the one recruited to crack the safes, right? He's like the grand
son orcus, of a bitch. Right?
So it's just strictly a heist, which still takes place in the world that it was kind of built.
Speaking of which, the
episode
is appropriate.
Oh, there you go. Nice shirt. But yeah, so things place in the world, Army of the Dead, with the zombie apocalypse is mentioned in the show.
And it's ongoing.
Right, it's ongoing. But yeah, the main focus here is on the heist. Right? So, I enjoy this. You know, it's, you know, as far as prequels go, it's not a great film by any stretch of imagination. But I love the character Sebastian. I think he's great. He's very entertaining, and he's unique to say least, but it works, right? He's very nerdy and kind of, you know, it's an oddball to say least, but the dynamic with the team, I forgot what's her face on Game of Thrones is in here.
She was the
right hand of Khaleesi.
But
she's in it, by the way. The dynamic to him is great. Yeah, some of the similar tropes that you do in most heist films, of course, but cool locations and, you know, the betrayals and yada yada yada. We've seen, there's nothing new here, but it's entertaining, really well shot. Zack Snyder produced it and directed. But the visual flair is still there. You can see his signature in there in terms of how the visuals presented. It was good, man. I was entertained by it, to be honest with you. I mean, you know, and it kind of leads right into Army of the Dead, right? The emotional part didn't quite hit in the end. I think that's a big miss mark, but for me anyway. But for the most
Did you?
part, it was fun.
I thought it hit actually at the end.
Really? Okay.
I mean, I felt it. I mean, I felt bad for him. At first, I didn't think that was the direction they were gonna take, right?
Correct.
Because I mean, it's kind of it's difficult because we know where Sebastian ends up after this, right?
Right.
But still, I think it hit the right note and not betrayal, but you know, sacrifice, right? That's, you know, can we spoil? Maybe
No,
no.
I'm not. Let's not spoil it. Let's not spoil it.
There's a sacrifice. The sacrifice that I think was well placed, and I think it emotionally hit. But that's not the point of the movie. That's
No,
not the point.
not at all. But it was fun. It was good. I mean, it was
It
entertaining
was
for what it
fun.
is. Yeah, listen, it's
Hey, man, when you have a Brad Cage reference,
Brad
of course.
Cage, you know, which is the background of this character, who's is Brad Cage. You know, his name is something else, but obviously he loves like American films, action films. He idolizes, you know, some of the stars. So he, I think he, his name Brad Cage is if Brad Pitt and Nicolas Cage had a baby, that would
That's
be it.
right,
So
there it
Brad
is.
Cage, you know, so he's like a psych, action junkie, he's a badass, whatever. But it was, like I said, it was fun and entertaining, and it was interesting because I almost thought that I think the emotional part would hit more if this movie had come out first, and then watching Army of the Dead, knowing, and if they could have maybe added something about his past in there, and then what happens to him because
Maybe, yeah,
he does die in
perhaps,
that.
but
Like, oh man, that sucks. Maybe he had a chance
well,
to,
well,
you know,
well.
to, but maybe I'm just.
We think he died. I'm hearing rumblings
Well,
that there's a character coming back in the third iteration, which is going to be called I don't know what it is. But so yeah, and that was the one thing
maybe.
I like about the movie because I think I picked a bone in that movie about why they had to kill him. Why did he have to sacrifice himself in
Correct.
that
Yes,
instance,
it was
right, with
unnecessary.
the
Yeah,
safe?
maybe you are.
I mean,
Maybe he's
he.
still. I doubt it, but it may, maybe you're right. Maybe he is. So. But again, if this movie would come out first, I thought it would be something different. But listen, it's good, man. Listen, with Netflix, you know, listen, 60% are crap. I say 30% are good. And, you know, this falls into that 30%, and 10% are great, right? It's very rare you get a great Netflix film. This is one of the 30%. This is one that's like, yeah, it's entertaining. If you liked Army of the Dead, it's the same kind of style, visual flair. So I liked it. It was entertaining enough. And I'm glad they didn't focus on the zombie part. This was strictly a heist film, right? You got like 2% zombies in this
Absolutely.
movie, right? For the most part. Some mentions, he's got some dreams about zombies, but that's really about it. For the most part, it's just strictly the heist. So if that's your cup of tea, I recommend it. It was fun. It was a good time.
Absolutely.
The other show that dropped was on HBO Max. That was Paradise Paraíso, for those who are Spanish inclined. A new international show. I think I read HBO is doing releasing a lot of new international content every month. This being one of them. So
Yes,
this. Yeah,
absolutely.
it's a Spanish show, so yeah, the subtitles, blah blah blah. And this was an interesting show. This is one takes place in the 90s. You have this I guess in this town where these girls have gone missing, and one of the girls' brothers is convinced that, you know, she's still alive, and him and his friends try to figure out what happened, where she at, and they stumble upon this, I don't know, spoiling thing, this supernatural events that are going on in that town, right? And then they are directly affected by it. So I guess, you know, last stuff for the afterlife, and I guess demons, I guess, is that for lack of a better word, as far as some of the things that they're experiencing. And I'll leave it at that.
Supernatural, yeah.
They dropped 4 episodes of this one so far. So, Chu, let's take lead on this one. What do you think about that? This one,
I think it's only 4 episodes.
I've only seen three, but they dropped four. Is it only four? I'm not 100%
I
sure.
think it's only four. I think
Oh,
they dropped the whole series. I could be
didn't
wrong,
know
but
that.
I checked on Rotten Tomatoes. I only saw 4 episodes listed. Because this actually, you know, they show when it actually came out. It came out during the summer, not on HBO Max, but international HBO Europe.
Right, of course, but they bring it
And
over to here for
so,
the States, yeah.
yeah. So my biggest part was only 4 episodes,
Oh, I didn't know that. Okay.
so yeah.
Okay. That's it. Short to the point then.
And I found a way to hear it in Spanish because I couldn't get the settings on it for us to just give me, but I was just getting the dub version,
Oh,
right, and
no,
subtitles.
mine automatically went to Spanish. It was, yeah. But
No,
either way, yeah.
I had to go to my Roku and put on the altered audio, and then I got the Spanish. I was like, this is better. I wanted to hear it in
Fair enough.
Spanish, right,
Fair.
for obvious reasons. All right, we're not called a Latin Nerds Network for nothing,
Of course, we don't. We don't do
dude.
subtitles here, so.
I thought it was good. I mean, I thought it was good. I thought interesting premise, interesting story. It should be short and sweet, right? If it's only 4 episodes, but it's part one anyway. And there's definitely obviously some supernatural elements that obviously led the interesting twist.
Yeah.
add to this story, right?
Yeah, it's hard to
what
talk
these
about because
kids.
you don't want to spoil it. But right when that
Yes.
event happens, I was like, okay, that's, interesting with the experience and inside the club, right? But Ace was this
Yes.
club, a kids party in the summertime. I guess it's closed or something. And the sister was missing from that point, so I went to go visit the club, and something happens,
Yes.
and it kind of
And it kind of
changes the
goes from
show
there.
a little bit, right? As far as perspective of the show. Yeah, it was fine. Like I said, I'm three in. I guess it's only four. Whatever. I'll see how it ends.
Yeah,
But
you said.
it's interesting watch. It's not great. The
It's
main
okay. It's a good, it's filler. It's
it
filler
really
for
is
what
better.
it's
The main
worth.
kid, I'm not a big fan of. It's I don't know. It's just something about him just annoys the shit on me. I don't know why. But whatever. But yeah, it's fine. It's interesting enough. And not knowing it's four episodes, okay, I'm more likely to recommend it because it's short to the point. And it's just enough interest there for some supernatural. I mean, this isn't Stranger Things, and I don't think it's really trying to be built as such, but you hear a premise, 90s supernatural kids, you kind of just your mind just wanders to Stranger Things, right? And this
But
is
if I
not
think
Stranger
with
Things.
Stranger Things, it's more horror, right? Versus this
Yeah.
is more demons and angels, right?
Right, yeah, for the
And
good, exactly,
ghosts
yeah,
type
and
of,
yeah,
right?
but it's not meant to be. They're not building it as a horror. No, yeah, Stranger Things was, but I
No.
mean, just the idea alone, right? You hear these things, you people with expectations, even mine's like, oh, cool, maybe it's like a Spanish version of Stranger Things, something in that
Things,
vein.
yeah.
Particularly taking place in the 90s, you can really rely on that nostalgia, which they don't do, right? They could have picked any timeline just before the cell phone era, anyway. But yeah, it was fine. It's decent. Like I said, yeah, nothing exciting, nothing. It's great, but good filler.
Yeah,
I would say, like
for
I said,
sure.
this was a very short week, and there's a couple of things coming out this week, later in the week. So I will just recommend it enough, but not a high recommend for me. I mean, again,
Yeah,
there's.
especially for episodes, why not? Because you
But
have
if, yeah,
time
for
for new
four
shows to come
episodes,
out
yeah,
this
they're
week.
about an hour apiece. So, I mean, these 4 hours are better than the 4 hours of Invasion. So, I mean,
That's for sure.
what is it at this point?
Something goes on here.
Right. So, but yeah, so, but that leaves it with that. But I mean, there's other show, like I finished Lock and Key too. I think, I assume you did too.
I'm almost, no, I haven't.
Okay,
I'm
yeah,
seven, eight,
okay, I
eight
finished
in.
it. Ended really well. Ended well. So a couple issues I had I don't want to talk about, but decent show that's out there.
The kid's so annoying, dude, but whatever.
The what?
The kid is annoying, dude.
Yeah, talk about
The
annoying
youngest
kids.
lock.
Yeah, it's
Yeah,
just, God,
exactly. I was like, yeah, you're trying to be like the last episode, you're trying to be on top, but he's locking chains. Like, dude, brother, please,
Yeah,
shut
it's just, yeah,
up,
he is on it. But
dude.
it's a good show. I enjoyed it. That's one you guys can
Yeah,
kind
still
of,
fun.
yeah,
Yeah,
two
it's
seasons
still
of
fun.
that. I did finish Inside Job. I thought it was really funny. I liked it a lot when I'm sure if Chewie caught that or not. 30-minute episodes in the vein of a Simpsons meets Rick and Morty. It's just so wacky. It's out there, but it's very funny, actually. But that being said, let's set you off for what's coming next week. We got a double the shows coming out this week in movies. So, a couple of things. We got Netflix on the 3rd is the Harder They Fall. It's a movie. I think it's
Yeah.
Antoine Fuqua director. So, yeah,
Western.
a legit director, a Western, Idris Elba, Regina King, among others. It's got some deep, decent reviews. Just,
King the Conqueror.
King the Conqueror, right? He's on there. Edwards, I forget his name.
Majors.
Majors, there you
Majors.
go. Yeah, they're in it, so it's got a great cast. Like Fuqua's work for the most part. It looks cool, so that's in the 3rd. It's got good reviews. So let's see. I mean, again, Netflix, I'm just hoping for that 30% range, right? I mean, I can't ask for the 10. It's difficult. Another one coming out on Apple Plus on the 5th, and that is Finch. This
Tom
feels
Hanks.
kind of Tom Hanks. I saw a trailer. I'm like, okay, so this is Castaway, take away the volleyball and add a dog. Basically, what's happened. And then throw
No, and don't
and throw a
forget
little
the
cha
other person was
yeah, a little
Chappie.
Chappie in there, for shits and giggles.
Chappie!
I can already see what this movie is just going to. I just got a feeling. It seems like it takes place in a, I guess, post-apocalyptic world, and
Yes.
he's the last man on Earth or whatever. So it seems like he found a dog and he built a robot to keep himself company. It looks like a snooze fest, man. I got a feeling about this one, but fine. I mean, I love Tom Hanks. I know he can carry anything, but I don't know, dude. Even Atlas needs a break, carrying her. He can't do it all the time. I don't think neither can Hanks. But I'm curious to see how this one turns out, Julie. I really am. We got Narcos season.
Season three. Narcos Mexico's
Mexico.
the final
It's the final
season
season
three.
three, right? Yeah, Narcos Mexico on the 5th. And I know you're a fan of the show. I am too.
Oh, hell
Yeah,
yeah, man.
it's really
I mean,
good.
here we get the conclusion of the story obviously never concludes, but
Right.
we'll probably get more of El Chapo, we'll get maybe Los Cielos, we'll get some more of the Mexican connection post the breakup or the arrest of Diego Luna's character. I can't remember what the guy's name was, right? He kind of put together the Mexican cartel, now
Right.
it's split up and very man for himself, essentially. But yeah, this looks great, man. I mean, this is a show we love back in the original Narcos with Pablo Escobar,
of course,
and a couple of years of then, and we get into the Rodriguez brothers and Cali, and now we've gone down to Mexico, so we've covered the gambit. So yeah,
Looking
love
forward
the show.
To. Yeah, it's a show I recommend people go watch. Because if you just you don't have to watch, you can watch the Pablo Escobar, which is just two seasons. Which is great, and then this one's things three. Three is like the fine, like the cutoff. Why I said I still recommend watching this series. Right?
Well, we had two of Pablo Escobar and one season of the Cali Cartel. Remember?
Oh, yeah, right. You're right.
So we had three in Colombia, and now three in Mexico.
Right.
Yeah.
Now it'll be three. So actually, it's only two seasons to catch up in the Mexico one. So I recommend. It's a really good show. Another one is an interesting one. Anime on Netflix, because Netflix dominating. What else is new? And that's on the 6th. I think it's next Saturday. It's called Arcane. Three episodes are dropping. Chewy, what's this one about? Because I'm not familiar with this one.
I don't know, man. I just saw some sci-fi anime. And so it's not an anthology. So it's a series. But I just don't know what the premise is. But from what I saw from the trailer, I mean, the animation looked pretty cool. Kind of in the vein of Cowboy Bebop, which is dropping the live action later. Well, this month. Well, November.
Later this month. Right.
Yeah. Next month, whatever. And so I caught my eye, caught my interest. I wanted to check it out and see, but I really don't know what the plot is or what the premise of the show is.
Yeah, I saw a little bit of animation. I mean, Netflix is good with anime. They do pretty well with that.
And, Castlevania was great.
Right, it has his niche of Transformers and early on, He-Man, a bunch of stuff, you know. I know it has his niche in Netflix with the anime stuff. So, but it looks good. I mean, animation looked really cool. I mean, what's good or not, we'll find out three episodes. So those are the four. So that being said, Chewy, I think that's all for the trick-or-treaters today. You know, hopefully, this week was solid. I mean, there's only two shows. It's, can't call it a great week. And then and when Invasion thrown in there, it just almost kind of ruined it for me.
I know.
But, you know, if you guys have insomnia, yeah, Invasion is the most watched show of the year. But now that being said, appreciate the viewership. Subscribe. Like the video below. Again, we're here every week letting you know what's coming out and set you up for the following week. We appreciate it. Chewy, always a pleasure as always. You guys have a good one.
Peace.